Are you by any chance John and Isabella's son?
One and the same.
Your commission is with Edward Braddock, is it not?
Aye. But he's yet to reach America, and I figured I might... Well, at least until he arrives, I thought...
Yes? Out with it.
Forgive me, sir. I had hoped that I might study under you. If I am to serve the Order, I can imagine no better mentor than yourself.
Kind of you to say, but I think you overestimate me.
Hello, impossible, sir. This way.
Bloody hell! Thief! Someone stop him!
Boston's quite a lively city.
There's all manner of things to see and do. Once you've settled in, I suggest you take some time to walk the streets. Who knows what opportunities you might discover?
Hold a moment. I need to fetch a few things before we get to work.
I'll arrange for horses while you do that.
Damned Springs. This accursed city will be the death of me.
You seem troubled, friend.
That's because I am. Greatly so, in fact.
What's happened?
I was robbed. The old Balkan file. Though I've managed to restore what's mine, I fear it's ruined.
You mean the book?
This is no ordinary book. It's an almanac. The first I ever wrote. Benjamin Franklin. Pleased to meet you.
Haytham Kenway.
You must be new to Boston.
Why do you say that?
You're still possessed of virtue. To stop and help an old lout like myself. I don't mean to impose, but you seem a spry fellow. Should you happen to find my missing pages, I'll reward you.
Look, I'm not sure if I...
It's all right, all right. If you have the time, hurrah. If not, no harm done. The thing is useless in its current state anyway. But should you somehow manage to restore it, you'll find me inside that general store over there.
Mechanical forging of all types. Well, that was interesting.
Mechanical forging of all dimensions and specifications. Price of me now represented in America by Lang and Associates. Has your pippin thrown a shoe? Need your tack adjusted? Collins Farriers of Needle Street. Place to go. News from France. The French political thinker and writer, the Baron de Montesquieu, has died at the age of 66.
Good day, sir. Yeah, come in.
from France. The French political thinker and writer, the Baron de Montesquieu, has died at the age of 66. Hostilities increase at the frontier as both French and British forces attempt to draw Indian allies to their side. Mechanical forging of all dimensions and specifications. Price of me, now represented in America by Lang and Associates. The widest assortment of dry goods, feed, and other staples.
We ride for the Green Dragon Tavern. The proprietors are eccentric, but the rooms are spacious and they do not pry.
Have you been told why it is I've come to Boston?
No. Master Birch said I should know only as much as you saw fit to share. He sent me a list of names and bade me ensure you could find them.
And have you had any luck with that?
Aye. William Johnson waits for us at the Green Dragon.
How well do you know him?
Not well, but he saw the order's mark and did not hesitate to come.
Prove yourself loyal to our cause, and you may yet know our plans as well.
I should like nothing more, sir.
You lying, cheating, no good son of a bitch.
Perhaps we've come at a bad time.
Oh, don't be foolish, dearies. Please, sit. Fancy something to eat? A drink, perhaps? Or is it a bed you require?
We've already let rooms here.
Of course. Masters Lee and Kenway, was it? I'll have your bags brought up. Do you require anything further?
Only privacy.
This way. Sir, William Johnson.
A pleasure. A good lad, if a bit earnest. I'm told you're putting together an expedition.
We believe there's a precursor site in the region. I require your knowledge of the land and its people to find it.
Sadly, my research has been stolen. Without it, I'm of no use to you.
Then we'll find it. Do you have any leads?
My associate, Thomas Hickey, has been making the rounds. He's quite good at loosening tongues.
Well, tell me where I can find him. I'll see if I can't speed things up.
We've heard rumors of bandits operating from a compound southwest of here. You'll likely find him there.
Charles?
Sir.
We'd best be off.
Of course.
Tell me about yourself, William.
What's to tell? I was born in Ireland to Catholic parents, which I learned early in life severely limited my opportunities. So I converted to Protestantism and journeyed here at the behest of my uncle. But I fear my uncle Peter was not the swiftest of men. He sought to open trade with the Conyan Gahaga, but chose to build his settlement away from the trade routes instead of on them. I tried to reason with the man, but... as I said... not the swiftest. So, I took what little money I'd earned and bought my own little plot of land. I built a home, a farm, a store, and a mill. Humble beginnings, but well situated.
Tell me about yourself, William.
What's to tell?
Thomas Hickey?
Who's asking?
Haytham Kenway.
Is that supposed to mean something?
Show some respect, boy.
Peace, Charles. William Johnson sent us in the hopes we might expedite your search.
I don't need no expediting. Don't need none of your fancy London speak, neither. I found the men that done the theft.
Then why are you just lazing around?
Figuring out how to deal with those varlets.
I have an idea.
Well, let's hear it.
I'll kill the lookout. Take up a position behind the guards. You two approach from the front. When I open fire on the group, you charge in. We have the element of surprise on our side. Half will fall before they've even realized what's happened. Into position, but wait for me to take the first shot.
You two, clear off.
Go on now, before you make us mad. Go on now, before you make us mad.
We'll be safe inside!
What now?
We can blow the door with those. Go on, shoot them. On with the show, then. Guess they wasn't so safe inside after all. Lay down your weapons, and I'll consider letting you live.
I make you the same offer. We've no quarrel. I only wish to return this chest to its rightful owner.
Nothing rightful about Mr. Johnson.
I won't ask again.
Agreed.
Your kind has no need for books and maps. Who put you up to this?
Never seen a person. It's always been dead drops and letters. But they always pay, so we do the jobs.
Well, those days are done. Tell your masters I said as much.
Who should I say you are?
You don't. They'll know.
Atham, this one's got some shot on him. You might want to be grabbing it on account of your pistol being parched.
A shame so many had to die.
Aye. Terrible tragedy, that. Back to the Green Dragon, then. I need a drink.
Don't let go of the chest, Charles. We'll take care of this rabble.
Thomas! What? Over there, that's what! Deal with them! A little help, please!
Quit your crying, I'm coming!
Look at those badgers, running around all ugly shut.
Wait, them bodies is sure to have loot on them. would be a shame to let it all go to waste.
Are you mad? In case you've forgotten, we're in the midst of something.
Aww. Why do you always gotta go forward and
just a few fools with knives. They ain't so tough.
It's not the scoundrels I'm concerned with.
Mr. Johnson's gonna need to double my pay after all this if he expects me to keep at his side.
There you are.
My thanks, Master Kinway. No. Tell me what it is you need.
The images on this amulet, are they familiar to you? Perhaps one of the tribes has shown you something similar.
It appears Kanyan Gahaga in origin.
Can you trace it to a specific location? I need to know where it came from.
With my research returned, perhaps. Let me see what I can do. Thomas!
What?
Rent yourself a room. And a bath as well. I suspect we'll be here for a while.
Evening, gentlemen.
Charming.
Oh, peace, Charles. He'll grow on you.
Oi! Catherine, you fussock! Get back here! Taddy needs a drink!
How fares the search?
Maths and maps are not cutting it.
What of your local contacts?
We'll need to earn their trust before they'll share what they know.
I have an idea on how we might be affecting that. There's a man who's taken to enslaving natives. Rescue him, and they'll owe us.
Do you know where they're being held?
Afraid not.
Benjamin Churchwell. He's a finder and a fixer. He's also on your list.
And there I was, wondering whom I might solicit next. Well done.
Wonderful. Charles?
Sir?
Seems like we're not the only ones looking for Mr. Church.
Damn it, he could be anywhere. What do we do?
We find him. I'll show you how.
Should we write his family, do you think?
Not our business to meddle, even if we've the best of intentions.
But if you could have seen it, they were surely drunk carrying on like that, and during the day, no less.
People of Boston, the earthquake on Cape Ann has demolished homes and churches. Help rebuild them if you are able.
What scandalous behavior from one who aims to be a surgeon. Not likely if he keeps up such carousing.
Truly a shameful display. Benjamin's parents would be mortified.
Perhaps I should send someone to retrieve him before he damages his reputation beyond repair.
They stumbled off to the northeast, no doubt in search of a tavern or some other place of ill repute.
Start questioning those on the street. I'm headed for higher ground.
Only one penny, a Boston Country Journal.
Time to take a listen. With luck, one of those people knows what became of Benjamin.
Shelter and Tweed Undertakers!
I've asked the criers, but they all plead ignorance.
Bugger that! They're lying!
Aye. But what can I do? Threats light off them, and I'll not deign to grovel.
Actions speak louder than words, my friend. Arrest one and put him in stocks. See if he's so glib then.
To do so without cause will set them singing songs about us. Last thing the city needs is town criers complaining about our abuse of authority.
And forget it! The crime is done. The killer's gone. Those who know won't share their secrets. If the city wishes to harbor scoundrels, let them pay the price for it.
though he's led to church, that one way or another, the debt would be settled. I don't envy the man.
Oh, what do you think they're playing?
All I know.
Me away. Insisted it was all under control.
How odd. Did they say what had happened?
No. Only that it was a trifling matter, and he'd be returned home soon. There was some blood, though, so I wonder if it wasn't more serious than they let on.
Where were they taking him?
Towards the hilltop. Perhaps there's a doctor at the fort.
What do you think they're planning?
All I know is it can't be good.
Probably looking for a nice, quiet place to do the deed. From what I hear tell, his work usually involves quite a bit of screaming.
Which reminds me, we'd best not buy any meat, Tundra.
Good call, that.
See, Charles? We'll have church in no time. Just as I said we would.
If I might ask, sir, where did you learn to do all this?
It is a requirement when you are raised in the manner that I was. Perception is fundamental to the order. It guides the feet when running and climbing, informs the hands when striking and fighting. But most important, it transforms the senses, and we begin to know the world in a different way. Careful. The place is well guarded. We need to slip past them. find the key. Wait here. Here we are then.
Why must you always make these things so difficult, Benjamin? Merely provide me with recompense, and all shall be forgiven.
I'll not pay for protection I don't need.
Clearly, you do require protection. Else we wouldn't be here. How very gauche. Now, what shall we do about our guest?
Maybe I take his hands. Put an end to his surgery. Maybe I take his tongue. Put an end to his waggling. Or maybe I take his cock. Put an end to his fucking us.
So many options. I can't possibly decide. Take all three.
Now, hold a moment. Perhaps I was hasty in refusing you earlier.
I'm so very sorry, Benjamin. But that door has closed.
Be reasonable, Silas!
I rather think I was. But you took advantage of my generosity. I won't be made a fool a second time. I fear I lack the constitution to bear witness to such barbarism. Come find me when you're finished, Cutter.
You'll regret this, Silas! Do you hear me? I'll have your head!
No. I rather think you won't.
Still a minute. I gotta decide where to start.
You're a ruffian. Commoner's dirt, Cutter.
I'm proud of it.
Your parents must be so very proud to have raised a specimen like you.
Quiet now. Please concentrate on me work. Maybe you'll get lucky and pass out. Though I dare say I'll do my best to ensure that doesn't happen. A little bit from here, a little bit from there.
Who are you?
Haytham Kenway, at your service.
I don't understand. Why are you here?
Walk with me, Mr. Church, and all will be explained.
Johnson's told me what you intend. As it happens, the man who held me is the same one that you seek. His name is Silas Thatcher.
That fancy lad is our slaver?
Don't let his velvet tongue deceive you. A crueler and more vicious creature I've never known.
What can you tell me of his operation?
He hosts at least 100 men, more than half of whom are redcoats.
All this for some slaves?
Hardly. The man's a commander in the king's troop, in charge of the Southgate Fort.
We need to find a way inside. Let me think on it. In the meantime, I'll attend to our final recruit.
John Pitcairn's our man. I'll take you to him.
State your business.
New recruit.
More kindling for the pyre, eh? Well, go on then.
How'd you manage that?
Did you forget, sir? My commission is with General Braddock. When I'm not attending to you, of course.
Pitcairn, you fool! Your acts are treacherous. Give me one good reason. I shouldn't kill you right now. Were you planning to announce yourself, or did you hope my men wouldn't notice your arrival?
If you'll allow me to explain.
Ho ho!
By all means. I should like very much to hear this.
I have not deserted, sir. I am here under Commander Amherst's orders.
Show me a letter bearing his seal, and you might be spared the gallows.
I have no such thing. The nature of my work, sir, it's...
It's the sort of thing best not put to paper.
Haytham.
General Braddock?
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised. Wolves often travel in packs.
Master Pitcairn won't be here for but a few weeks. I shall return him to his proper post once our work is finished.
The devil's work, no doubt. It's bad enough my superiors have insisted. I grant you use of Charles. But they've said nothing about this traitor. You'll not have him.
Edward, listen to reason.
We're done here. See these gentlemen out.
Well, that didn't go as I expected.
And to think I used to call him brother.
What now? They'll chase us off if we try and return.
We're done with this camp. As luck would have it, so are they. Come along.
What are you planning?
To steal Master Pitcairn.
What?
You'll see. Now, when I give the signal, you're to distract Braddock's patrol and lure them into a dead end.
Stein Marlborough?
No. Its residents are too content. Their homes are nice, their days untroubled.
What of Lynn or Ship Street?
Yes. Those fresh arrived are often soon in dire straits. They're more likely to seize upon an opportunity to fatten their purses and feed their young.
Scoundrels, one and all! Fie on you and your false war! After him!
Unhand him, Edward.
You again.
Let us go. And John Pitcairn with us.
I will not have my authority challenged.
Nor I.
Put them all in chains.
Stay my hand today because you were once my brother. and a better man than this. Or should our paths ever cross again, all debts will be forgotten. You're free now, John.
Traitor! Go on, then. Join them on their fool's errand. And when you find yourself lying
broken... I assume you've good reason for causing all this madness. What is it you require of me?
I'll explain everything on the way. Hello again. More almanac pages? Not quite. It's a treatise, actually. Oh? Concerning what? The benefits of taking an older woman as a lover. Really? This I'd like to hear. First and most obvious, they're wiser. And so this makes for far more stimulating conversation. Makes other things more stimulating as well, but more on that in a moment. All right. Your argument for experience makes some sense. Second, when beauty fades, women must improve their utility, lest they be discarded and forgotten. Rare is an old woman who is not also kind, compassionate, and good. That's something of a generalization. But also true. Now, on to the third. Older women cannot conceive, which means one less thing over which to fret. In fact, you also decrease the chance of acquiring something like the French pox, its presence clearly visible, or the woman dead. And should one desire a child? Then make a young woman your wife. Let the older one be a mistress. And that brings me to my fourth point. With age comes prudence. An older woman is less likely to reveal your indiscretions. Yes. I suppose you know quite a bit about that. And proud of it, thank you. As to the fifth reason, because in every animal that walks upright, the deficiency of the fluids that fill the muscles appears first in the highest part. The face first grows lank and wrinkled, then the neck, then the breast and arms. The lower parts continuing to the last as plump as ever, so that covering all above with a basket and regarding only what is below the girdle, it is impossible of two women to know an old from a young one. And as in the dark all cats are gray, the pleasure of corporal enjoyment with an old...
Thank you. Transport me between the city and Point South.
Rapier, does your cutlass cut less? Retain the
should be obviated from your itinerary. Until such time as repairs have concluded. If you've a delicate problem, need to tend it to. Jack Fredericks is your man. Discreet, efficient, and cheap. Willing to consider all offers. Only one penny. The Boston Country Journal. The widest assortment of drivers. Thank you. The Boston Country Journal. The world for a penny. manufactory buildings.
Thank you. call upon John Cooper for 7 generations.
Hear ye. Shots fired in anger in the colony of Pennsylvania.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, I believe I found the solution to our problem. Or rather, Odysseus has.
Oh, do you? Are you a new guy?
The Greek hero, you lobcock.
Allow me to explain. We enter Silas' fort under the pretext of kinship. Once inside, we spring our trap, free the captives, and kill the slaver.
Dodgy, dodgy. I like it.
Then, let us begin. First, we need to find ourselves a convoy. Signal.
Understood, sir.
If we time this right, we can catch them all unawares. Williams serve as vanguard. Let no man reach us.
What about me?
You and John will follow from a distance and keep watch over us. I'll signal you when I have need of your services. We're here to help you, along with those held inside Southgate Fort.
Free me.
Not until we're inside the gate. You can't chance an inspection of the gate going wrong. I'll see you safe. You have my word. Do you know anything of Silas' operation? How many men we might expect? The nature of their defenses? You must be rather important to him if you are given your own escort.
Sir, we've enemies ahead. Shall I engage them?
No. Let Jonathan and Thomas take care of it.
As you wish.
I wish you'd trust us. Though I suppose it's only natural for you to be wary. So be it.
To meet the Reaper.
fresh meat, eh?
On your guard, man.
Come here. I want to take a look.
Of course.
Only say the word, and I'll cut them down.
One moment there. Me and you.
Engage the enemy.
Looks like you're to meet the Reaper.
All clear.
Evening, gentlemen.
State your business.
Delivery for Silas.
Go on.
See? I'm freeing you just as I said I would. Now, if you'll allow me to explain. Let her go.
But she'll give us away.
No, she won't.
What's the plan?
Free the captives and avoid detection.
What of Silas?
He dies.
I know when you're ready to strike. Signal when you're ready to strike.
patrol with us.
So said Silas.
I assume it's all rather straightforward. Watch for disturbances, ensure order is maintained.
Signal when you're ready to strike.
Thank you.
Stop slouching, soldier.
Beg pardon?
I said stop slouching. Stop slouching, soldier.
Beg pardon?
I said stop slouching.
An hour of quiet was all I asked. Instead, I'm awakened not 10 minutes later by this cacophonous madness. I expect an explanation, and it had best be good. How? How did this happen? My precious merchandise set free? It's unacceptable! Rest assured, I'll have the heads of those responsible. But first we clean up this mess. Seal the fort, kill any who try to escape. I don't care if they be one of us or one of them. To approach the gate is to be made a corpse. Am I understood?
Push them back!
Go on, Hatem! We'll hold back the guards while you deal with them.
Have you with us? I could use some help.
Back, you fucking fox.
He's the one responsible. Kill him.
I'll fill it through like a
Who are you?
Name's Hatem Kenway. You don't know me, but I believe the two of you are well acquainted.
I made a promise to you, Silas. One I intend to keep.
What happens now?
We wait. And not for very long, I suspect.
It's been several weeks now since we freed the Mohawk prisoners from captivity. I had hoped their leader might make contact, but there's been only silence. My men grow restless. They want to know what comes next, and I do not have an answer. Lee alone remains active, pursuing leads, however slight. He stalks the city streets and scouts the bordering woods, hopeful that he might make contact with one of those we saved. There was a woman there that night. It was she who helped the others to safety. If we can find her, I believe I'll have my answers. So, I watch and wait, hopeful that my true mission might finally begin.
Hello, Charles. Any luck finding our mystery woman?
Word is she's been stirring up trouble just outside the city in a town called Lexington.
Well, then that's where we begin our search. I'll meet you there. Have you found her?
She's made camp not too far from here.
Excellent. Well, the sooner we're done, the sooner we can get out of this cold.
We'll move faster. I'm afraid I have some bad news, sir.
Oh?
Braddock is insisting I return to service under him. I've tried to beg off, to no avail.
No doubt he's still angry about losing Pitcairn. Say nothing of the shaming we gave him. Do as he asks. In the meantime, I'll work on having you released.
I'm sorry for the trouble.
Not your fault.
We're too late.
Fire's only just been snuffed. Snow recently disturbed. She's close.
Bollocks.
These tracks are fresh. They must be hers. Seems she took to higher ground. Out of the snow and into the trees.
Wait here.
Oh, damn it. Wait! Come back! Do you return to Braddock, Charles, before he grows suspicious? I can handle things from here.
But, sir!
But nothing! Go! Stop running! I only wish to talk! I am not your enemy! Please just hear me out! Gods, woman! Only let me speak! Enough with these games! It is imperative that we speak! A moment of your time...
Try my patience, woman!
Are you touched in the head?
Me, Haytham. I come in peace.
Why are you speaking so slow?
Sorry.
What do you want?
Well, your name, for one.
I'm Gadzidzio.
Well, pleased to meet you. Gadzidzio.
Just call me Zio.
Dio.
Zio.
Dio.
Now tell me why it is you're here. Where did you get this?
From an old friend.
I've only seen such markings in one other place.
Where?
Well, it is forbidden for me to speak of it.
I saved your people. Does this mean nothing to you? Look, I am not the enemy.
Close to here, there is a hill. Meet me there, and we'll see if you speak the truth. That town hosts soldiers who seek to drive my people from these lands. They're led by a man known as the Bulldog.
Edward Braddock.
You know him?
He is no friend of mine.
Every day, more of my people are lost to men like him.
Then I suggest we put a stop to it. Together.
What do you propose?
That we kill Edward Braddock. But first, we have to find him.
I don't trust you.
I know.
Yet you remain.
That I might prove you wrong. Wait here. A Mohawkman is likely to raise suspicions, if not muskets.
This is hardly the first time I've been amongst your people. I can handle myself.
I hope so.
I hear tell the French are readying to move on our positions. Wonder what Braddock intends to do about it.
He's already left for the advance camp. I'll wager our little holiday here is just about ended. We'll be marching south before week's end.
Can't stand being quartered there. The endless crashing of the waves, the sting of the salt in my eyes, and the goddamn gulls shrieking and shitting everywhere.
You're sure that's where we're going?
Aye. The Bulldog's putting together another expedition.
That's what they're calling them now. Expeditions.
Aye. Smart, too. Slap a fancy name on something and all evil is excused.
Oi! Where are you going, Cully?
Me?
No, the other cock Robin.
Well, I was leaving.
Oh? And now?
Well, now, I'm going to feed you your teeth.
And you were worried I was going to be the problem? You're hurt.
Oh, it's nothing.
Here. This should stop the bleeding.
That wasn't necessary. But thank you.
We should move on. Meet me at Braddock's camp when you're ready.
Thank you.